Good afternoon. Good morning. Look, I don't even care. Greetings. Today, I'm very upset. I have to voice this opinion. I'm not angry. I just want to voice an opinion because I'm getting sick of it. I'm getting, you know, tired of Africans, Nigerians especially, denying their heritage, denying their culture. It's now a competition to see who has the more refined accent, who has changed his accent. You see someone talking about, oh, I've been in America for 12 years. Yeah, you know, I'm changing my accent. And then the next fool will be like, I've been here for 20 years. My accent is totally gone. No, let God punish you and your accent. What is refined about your accent? Is there an accent refinery that nobody is telling me about? What is inferior about your accent? Why can't you adapt and love who you are? And yet we love when the Hispanics or any people from any other cultures, you know, they may be born and bred wherever, but they're still authentic with who they are. When the mom talks to them, oh, mamacita, okay, paso te pete karaoke. And you're like, wow, that's impressive. But yeah, when you speak to your own child in your native tongue, they will look at you like, mom, what are you talking about? Clap for yourself. Congratulations, you played yourself. Mugu. It's very sickening. Yet you won't see Nigerians when they go to India or Chinese or somewhere else. They don't change accents. When they go to Pakistan, they don't change accents. When they go to London for 6 months, they come back and say, yeah, Ulu, my friends. Ulu, which friends? Ulu, what is Ulu? Expired imbecile. God will punish you. Idiot. When you go to India, you don't see them come back, oh, my name is Tunde. I lived in Calcutta for 12 years. I was a grasscutter. But yet, when they go to America for 2 weeks, they come back with a refined accent. Let me hear who tell me to refine my accent again. The type of slap, the type of boxing combination I'll give you, your dead grandparents will feel it. Idiot. It's disgusting to think about. And yet, when they say, oh, who are the Nigerians here? You raise your hand. Who are the Africans? You raise your hand. Oh, who can speak African language? You're now looking around. No, you should be able to speak your language. And I don't care. I understand that there are people born into different environments and out of your culture. Like I know certain Chinese people born and bred in Jamaica, they picked up the Jamaican patois. You understand? They can speak the Jamaican patois. And they're not really in that much inclined with their own language and culture. That's okay. That's permissible. You're trying. I understand that. But if you're a Nigerian, born and bred in America, you live with your parents, surrounded by other Nigerians, you don't have any excuse not to learn your language. You don't have any excuse not to learn your language or to know about your culture. You ask a Nigerian that claims a Nigerian, what is the capital of Nigeria? I think my uncle lived in Lagos, so it's Lagos. What? Jesus Christ. God. What? What do you talk? God will visit two people one day. Refine you and your refined accent. Thunder fire you. I'm Weber.